thank you. Welcome to Edgewater High School, our gracious host for this season's Young Artist Orchestra Concert. We know that you are here to see these incredible young musicians perform for you, and we're going to get to them in just a moment. As you saw in that video, Ethan, our entire young artist team, these students, and us at CFCRS are committed to making sure that these experiences are fun and engaging and immersive, and that we're giving everybody on the stage a chance to feel like they are part of something really special. So today's concert does have a few surprises in store for you, singers and dancers and actors and more, but the real star of the show today are these musicians that are right here behind me. So to make sure that they know how excited you are for this experience, can you give them a really big round of applause right now, please? Far they've come, and hear this incredibly diverse and exciting music that they're going to perform for you today. My name is Justin. I work here at CFC Arts as the Vice President of Creative and Production. Central Florida Community Arts is a lot of things to a lot of people. This is a huge part of who we are, giving our best and our youngest the opportunity to perform, the chance to be on a stage, to work with great musicians and great leaders, and to perform for a wonderful audience. Please check out cscarts.com/events for tickets to any of our upcoming shows, and get ready to really enjoy yourselves. They're gonna give you their best, and we're gonna ask you to do the same in return. So make sure you're ready to cheer them on and have a great time this afternoon. So please, without anything else from me, enjoy Eye of the Tiger, presented by our Young Artist Orchestra and Mr. Ethan Love.
Thank you. welcome everyone to our Young Artist Orchestra as we present Eye of the Tiger. Now, I'm sure our theme of our concert is pretty evident from our first song, being the name of the piece, Eye of the Tiger, but we want to take that theme a little bit farther today. So the theme, Eye of the Tiger, I got this theme because my favorite movie in the whole world when I grew up, because of my dad, was Rocky. It was about someone who nobody knew, who ended up becoming the heavyweight champion of the world. And what I love about that story is it took this tenacity, this grit, this determination, regardless of where you came from, how much money you got, how much training you had. He had hard work and he believed in himself. And that's that Eye of the Tiger, right? It's what we call the underdog story. And so the whole theme of our concert today is all about discovering the underdogs in the world and celebrating those people, fictional or non-fictional, like Rocky Balboa today. Now we're going to take it into the non-fictional realm and talk a little bit about the Olympics. There was someone who nobody knew. Nobody knew their name before that 2016 Olympics, but then everyone knew their name after.
I'm Jair, and I'm from the beautiful islands of Puerto Rico. So, Monica Puig grew up in Miami and was born in Puerto Rico's capital, San Juan. Her mother, Astrid, was her first tennis coach and introduced her to the game. Puig turned pro at age 16 and was the number 2 seed in the 2010 Youth Olympic Games in Singapore. But even still, no one had ever really heard of Monica Puig. But on August 13th, 2016, the world knew Monica Puig. It was the day that she won the Olympic gold medal. Puig beat major champions Gabriel Muguruza, Petra Kvitova, and Angelique Kerber en route to the title, upsetting 3 Grand Slam winners. Puig announced herself to the world in the 2016 Games in Rio de Janeiro. "In every match, I got better and better," Puig said. "I started getting faster and I started getting more powerful. I started believing in myself more. With every match that passed, I continued to learn and continued to grow." Puig moved on to the final, where she would face Grand Slam champion Germany's Angelique Kerber. Kerber, who was the number 2 player in the world, reigning Australian Open champion and Wimbledon runner-up, forced Puig to play her second consecutive 3-set match at the tournament. 2 hours and 9 minutes later, Puig won Puerto Rico its first Olympic gold medal, with her more dramatic points leading fans to shout, "Sí se puede," which is Spanish for "yes, we can," and waving the flag to Puerto Rico. The crowd included the president of Puerto Rico's Olympic committees, Sara Rosiano Velez. When we asked Velez for a comment, she simply said, "This is a great day for all the Puerto Ricans that live in Puerto Rico and around the world."
I think it's super important for us to, throughout this concert, to remember the names of the people who have truly encouraged and engrossed that whole underdog story that we talk about, like Rocky Balboa, like Monica Puig. Can anyone raise their hand? Does anyone know who Monica Puig was? Has anyone heard of the name? Great, now today you do, right? A beautiful underdog story of someone from the island of Puerto Rico giving their first ever Puerto Rican gold medal. That was super special for the island. And what I love about this is now our newer generation get to know about the Karate Kid through a new Netflix show called Cobra Kai, right? It kind of intermingles the old Karate Kid with the new Karate Kid, even has the original actors. I think it's so cool. And that's another beautiful story, right? Mr. Miyagi, who doesn't know about that? Wax on, wax off, about the patience it took to get him to where he needed to be. And it was a super special movie that was very successful. And we're going to play a piece from that that was written specifically for the movie called Glory of Love. And what I love about what we're doing this year is we're getting to highlight so many ensemble members, right? So we have a weekly challenge called the Practice Champions Assignment. I give them a certain passage I want them to practice, and all they have to do is send me a video. They may think it's terrible, but participation is what matters to me. I believe in effort well over quality, right? Quality will come as long as the effort begins, right? So these are all students who participated in those weekly Practice Champions Assignments, and I wanted to highlight them to let them know how much I appreciated that. So this is our first ever CFC Arts Young Artist Orchestra String Quintet. Let's give them a round of applause.
How's I supposed to know it would take 10 hours?
There's something wrong with your sister.
What do you mean?
She's got a stick up her butt.
Yeah, it's because she's been dating that jerk, Steve Harrington.
Yeah, she's turning into a real jerk.
She's always been a real jerk.
Nuh-uh, she used to be cool. Like that time she dressed up as an elf for our Dungeons & Dragons campaign.
That was 4 years ago.
Hey, if I ever play D&D with you guys, do I get one of those cool campaign shirts?
Max, are you kidding? Absolutely. Everyone gets one. We wear them to all of our games and... You're being sarcastic, aren't you? She was being sarcastic. Whatever. Later, guys.
Night, Dustin. Later, Lucas.
Night, Mike.
It was seven.
Huh?
The roll. It was a seven. Demogorgon in the game. It got me.
Oh.
See you tomorrow.
Yeah, see you tomorrow, Will.
Oh, whoa. Hi, are you okay?
Okay, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to freak you out. I'm Mike. What's your name? Where did you come from? Are you in some sort of trouble?
11.
Huh?
My name is 11.
Oh, okay, cool. Come with me.
Lucas, do you copy? It's Dustin. Lucas!
Hey, it's Lucas.
I know it's you. Then say over when you're done talking so I know when you're done. Over.
I'm done. Over.
I'm worried about Will. He's been missing for way too long. Over.
Yeah. This is crazy. Over.
You know, I was thinking. Will could have cast protection last night, but he didn't. He cast fireball. Over.
What's your point?
My point is that he could have played it safe, but he didn't. He put himself in danger for the rest of the party. Over.
Do you think that's what's happening now? He's putting himself in danger to help Hawkins? Over.
Help Hawkins from what?
Max?
Max, you have to say over when you're done talking.
Who cares? Help Hawkins from what?
I think I might know.
Mike?
Can someone please just say over when they're done talking?
You know how people always talk about there being other dimensions? Other worlds? That there could be a parallel universe? Just like ours, but different?
Like an evil one? Like Veil of Shadows?
Yeah, sure.
Veil of what?
I think there's a parallel universe underneath Hawkins. A bad one, and that's where Will is.
But how do we get there?
Yeah, how do we get to the Upside Down?
We would need a massive amount of energy, but I think I might have just found someone. Meet me at 10, I'll explain everything. Over.
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 Not like it was before. It's grown. A lot. And that's considering we can even get through the gates. The lab is going to be crawling with those dogs.
Demodogs.
What?
You know, like Demogorgon and dogs. You put the two words together. Sounds pretty cool.
How is that important right now?
It isn't. Sorry.
I can do it. I can stop it.
You're not hearing me.
I'm hearing you. I can do it.
Even if I can, there's still another problem. If the brain dies, the body dies.
I thought that was the whole point.
It is, but if you're really right about this, if El closes the gate and kills the Mind Flayer's army...
Will is a part of that army.
Closing the gate will kill him.
Then we have to stop giving the Mind Flayer what it wants. If Will is the host, then we have to make the host uninhabitable. Then,
we can close the gate for good.
We have to save Will. Now!
Just... be careful, okay? I can't lose you. Again.
You won't lose me.
Promise?
Promise. Now go. Save Will. It's time.
once quiet town of Hawkins, Indiana, has spent time in a place that they never expected, the national spotlight. Residents told us that they thought they lived in a town where, they say, nothing ever happens. Well, what do you think?
Max? Max, please, wait!
Lucas, can you just wait with everyone else?
I know something's happening to you. Is it Vecna?
I told you, I'm fine, okay? I mean, as fine as anyone who is hurtling towards a gruesome death can be.
Max, you know you can talk to me, right?
Yeah, I know that.
Then why are you pushing me away? Just talk to me, to your friends. We're right here, okay? We're here.
Just quit with everyone else. This won't be long. Dear Billy, I don't know if you can even hear this. Not too long ago, I would have said that it was impossible. But that was before I found out about the altered dimensions and monsters, so I'm just gonna stop assuming that I know anything. Basically, ever since you left, everything's been a total disaster. For a while, I tried to be happy, normal. But I think maybe a part of me left that day too. And I haven't told anyone this, I just can't. But I had to tell you, if you can even hear this. I'm so, so sorry, Billy.
Max, please, wake up, please!
Her song. What's your favorite song?
What?
Robin said if she listens to her favorite song, it could help her pass back through the gate and get away from Vecna.
That makes no sense!
What's her favorite song?
Long here.
Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. That was our assistant director, Nathan Humphreys, conducting for you today. You know, to make things like this happen, it requires a huge team effort. And a lot of people you rely on, that you trust, and I am so grateful for the people I surround myself with that I can trust and rely on so we can put together these wonderful concerts. I want to thank a couple of people. You just saw Nathan, my assistant, as well. We also have our administrator, Jay, who is setting up microphones as we speak. And because the beautiful thing about our CFC Arts Orchestra is that we start anyone who at least has a year of experience on their instrument, all the way up to if you're a senior in high school and you've got lots of experience. We want a place for everyone, and that's what's important to us, to build community here. Now, that's tricky when we choose music, right? Because we want to make sure we still challenge those older ones, but that can be sometimes overwhelming for our newer ones. So we have adult volunteers from our adult symphony orchestra at CFC Arts that come out of their time for free, volunteer to help these kids. And my heart and my thankfulness and my gratefulness cannot be any bigger. Will you please stand, all my adult volunteers, so you can recognize me. The song got really famous out of an animated feature called Shrek 2. We're gonna do the Shrek 2 version for everyone up here, but I hope you've enjoyed today. I hope you've enjoyed learning about the underdogs of fictional and non-fictional life, and know that no matter where you come from, you can do great things, right? And that's important. And these people right here, these people are doing great things. So let's give them another hand. The CFC Arts Young Artist Orchestra is proud to present Holding Out for a Hero.
Thank you.
so much, everyone, for joining us on our musical journey of underdogs and champions. Have a wonderful rest of your Sunday. Thank you for your children. Thank you so much for the students up here. Thank you so much for investing in them and for believing that music is important, because it is. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful day.